Thank you for the opportunity to speak here today. As I said in the introduction, I work for Rackspace. Now, Rackspace is a cloud computing company. And from a practical perspective, that means that we are on the backside of all of your phones, all of your computers, all of your tablets. Congressman Venerable earlier this morning was working on his iPad and using the cloud to access his email. Those sorts of records are the ones that Rackspace manages. The Fourth Amendment gives us the right to be secure in our papers and effects. And for most of the past 200 years, the Fourth Amendment has been interpreted in a very physical manner because most of the time our papers have been physical. Looking around, there are a lot of people here who are attorneys. You know, I remember the time when there was a secretarial pool, and every morning the morning memos would come out. They had been typed up overnight. And in that sort of arrangement, it was essential that you manage the physical security of your documents, because being secure in that sense meant locking the doors. But over the past 20 years, society has changed in a very fundamental way. Everything went digital. We started keeping our papers, our letters, our business records, our databases, everything, all of our communications on computers. And as a result, what we need to do now is keep those properly under control using digital locks, in short, encryption. Now, our electronic records now are our papers and effects. Our work, our ambitions, our lives, they are all represented digitally, and they're all on computers. Now, just because these computers have given us the ability to access and recall and index and catalog our lives so extensively, those things bring great help to everybody. I know that I have so many emails that I rely on the search function in order to find any particular one. But opening up those same sorts of capabilities to everyone, everywhere, through some sort of through mandating a golden key or an unencrypted backdoor is opening ourselves up for trouble. We at Rackspace hold people's financial information, their bank records, and their notes back and forth with their businesses, with their doctors, with their lawyers, and with their spouses. And I want to emphasize the ways in which we do work with law enforcement. We have one member of our team whose job is almost exclusively dedicated to working with and helping requests from law enforcement. Although we insist on proper and full documentation with every request, we've been told that we're one of the easier companies to work with because we have a process and we respect the requirements to be able to get to some of that information. But the fact that all of our lives are searchable and catalogable and manageable with computers doesn't change the fundamental intent of our founders. We should still be secure in our papers and effects, even though those effects are now written on flash drives instead of on paper. Now, it's been frequently said, just because you can do something doesn't mean you should do something. We come from a tradition of limited government where every person has the ability to, where we believe in the fundamental goodness of people and the right of each person to pursue life, liberty, and pursue happiness. But let's approach this from a practical perspective. One thing that's gotten lost in the debate over unencrypting and decrypting iPhones is that the Fourth Amendment isn't just about crime and punishment. It is also one of the fundamental foundations of American business. One reason that people traditionally wanted to do business in the United States is because we provide strong protections for privacy. Privacy is necessary for business deals, for trade secrets, for intellectual property of all kinds to really have effect in the marketplace. One of the things that sets the United States apart is that from other countries is that everybody has the right to know the rules and to know that the rules are going to be followed, and that you can go about your business without worrying about somebody looking over your shoulder. But I have to tell you that this has changed in the past couple of years. The United States, and Rackspace in particular, has been damaged by some of the revelations that our computing infrastructure has been under surveillance for so much of the time. For the sake of our commercial competitiveness alone, your Act Score supports efforts like the End Warrantless Surveillance of Americans Act. Speaking particularly of the Feinstein-Burr bill that has been referred to a couple times recently, I can say with 100% assurance that it would be the death knell of all commerce, that allowed electronic commerce in the United States. We are already less competitive, but mandating unencrypted access to all information by anyone without whom to control it would mean that any international company, and even any company that happened to have business both in the United States and abroad, which is essentially all of the Fortune 1000, would mean that we would not be a reasonable place to do business for the rest of the world. We would be instantly exporting all of our competitiveness overseas. Thinking back even just a couple of weeks, we had a circumstance where we were locked out of some business in our UK data center for things that would be stored in the United Kingdom because they were too worried about rack space being subject to United States law. I can only imagine what they thought right after they heard about the Feinstein-Burr bill. Finally, we need to think about this from a practical perspective. From Rackspace, we have this idea of what's inside the box versus what's outside the box. What's inside the box, or inside the computer, is managed by our customer. What's outside the box, the physical hardware and the network, is managed by Rackspace. We don't have access to our customer's data. And that is not because we're trying, again, to avoid it being turned over into the hands of the authorities. But it's simply so that we don't get legally enmeshed with our customers. If we had ongoing, regular, indexed access to our customers' data, then that would, first of all, put on us all sorts of compliance regulations. We know that many of our customers store, for example, HIPAA-related data, very sensitive information, financial records, trade secrets. We simply cannot have access to that information without also accepting the heightened responsibilities associated with the management of that information. Finally, they would not be able to trust us with that information if we did not have it without having to take into account all 6,000 members of our company as part of their security perimeter. This is an extremely important debate. We're thankful to be part of it, and we look forward to the further discussion. Thank you.
Mr. Hoffman.
Good morning. Thank you to the members of the